So I'm at the port of Aleppo. This is my first dungeon that I'm trying out as a free trial player. What I'm doing now is actually checking my gear to see what I can buy from the vendors in order for me to upgrade my gear to increase my chances of success in the dungeon. I have to be very careful in how I spend my gil because I do not have much gil, as I do not have the access to the trade or to the market in order for me to craft and sell items and earn gil. So I'm going through the list of gear that I can possibly buy with a reasonable price. I'm not sure whether all the gear will have the same price in all the vendors across the different locations, whether in cities or in the field or in the outskirts. I do not know any info about this, and I'm not sure whether I'm paying additional gear by buying the gear at this location rather than to buy it at the city or in the city. Anyway, I need this gear, I think, in order to increase my chances of success in the dungeon. I hope that I'm making the right choice and spending my gil in an efficient way. So these are some of the gear items that I've selected to upgrade and to equip. I actually did not know that I can update the gear set by pressing the Y button. Previously, or maybe in this case as well, I would go into the gear set, I would add a new gear set, and then I would remove the old gear set. And then I realized that, you know, the interface is telling me that I can just update the gear set simply by pressing on the Y button. So I did not know about this, and you know, I did not save the time, yeah, in doing so, instead of creating a new gear set and then removing the old gear set, which is quite silly of me. So I guess I've made the preparations. Now I'm going to go over to the dungeon. I do not have any mount, so everywhere I go, I need to actually run or walk to the location, which is actually quite tedious. But since I do not have a mount, that is the only way to travel at the moment. So here I decided to try to do some training and increase my experience before I actually go into the dungeon. I think this kind of training will provide me, or at the Hall of Novice, I just noticed it, that's how it is called. I think there is a reward that will upgrade, not only will it give me experience, but I think it will also give me some gear as well. So I decided to complete the training at this area, or at least one phase of the training at this area, before I enter the dungeon to upgrade whatever gear that I have and to increase my chances of success in completing the dungeon. Final Fantasy XIV is actually my first game using a controller. Before this, I have never used a controller. I find using a controller is quite a good experience for me. I always thought that I would be very bad in using the controller, but somehow Final Fantasy XIV is suited for the controller. In my case, of learning how to use the controller for the first time. So I find the movement and also the combat with the controller quite, in a way, it's not too difficult, and perhaps it's maybe even better than using the keyboard and the mouse. At least that's my current experience. So I'm actually quite happy to get some reward in terms of experience, skill and equipment, which I can use to perhaps upgrade my current gear set. Yes, the item that I received from the trainee is actually able to upgrade my current gear set. So this is why I think it is good for beginners like us to actually do the trial or do the training before entering the dungeon. At least this is my case, because the current gear set that I have is even lower than the item rewarded by the training. I'm also very happy that I can use NPC instead of looking for other members through the LFG or with the party system, because I'm afraid that I'm just a novice and then nobody would actually want to do a low level dungeon like this with me. Okay, so this is my first experience in entering a dungeon. I'm actually quite happy to see the cutscene, and I think this is actually very nicely done. Sometimes I find the active help a bit disturbing, because I'm looking at the current update on the screen and then the active help just pop up, and then I can't, you know, sometimes it covers over the interface and I'm not able to actually see what is behind it, and then I have to finish reading the active help first. Which is actually very useful for me, because I need to know all this information as I'm playing this game for the first time. The active help is actually relevant information that I can use to actually better my gameplay. But sometimes the way it pops up, it actually sort of like covers the other information that is being updated or being displayed by the game. And what happens is that I can't read both, because the active health interface is actually interfering with the gameplay's interface or whatever the game is displaying. Perhaps I should sort of like use the HUD setting to actually put the active, if it's possible, to put the active health interface at one side or at one corner. Yeah, and then there's actually so many actions and roles and traits that I do not quite understand yet. And I actually have to constantly read through it to remember what they actually do. And then how to actually put all the necessary actions or the actions that I use frequently into the hotbar in order to for me to use the actions in a way, yeah, efficiently during combat. And these are still things that I'm learning. And to switch between different hotbars is also something that I need to cope with, and that's something that I need to learn. Here I'm trying to actually edit my hotbar, and you can see I'm really struggling with it because I do not know yet that I have so many hotbars that I can switch to, and then I'm not used to the controller. For this is the first time, yeah, I'm using the controller, as I've mentioned before, and yeah, so it's, you know, quite difficult for me to actually edit the hotbar. Sometimes I really struggle with the target system. I'm not sure what option should I choose. As you can see here, when there are many enemies clustered in a single area, I find it very difficult to actually find my target properly using the sort of like the keys here on the controller. Maybe this might be easier with the keyboard and mouse, but I'm not sure. Maybe it's as difficult as using the controller as well. But I find it a bit difficult for me at the moment when there are many enemies clustered together. I find it difficult to actually select the proper enemy to fight against, or the enemy that I should target so that I can help the NPCs to effectively or quickly kill off the enemy. Actually, I'm very appreciative of the NPCs. If it's not for the NPCs attracting the attention of or aggroing the attention of the mobs and the bosses, I do not think I would be able to survive the dungeon and defeat the monsters and the bosses. So this is the final boss of the dungeon. I always enjoy watching cutscenes and I do not skip them. I know that Final Fantasy has a lot of good cutscenes for the story, so I'm trying my best to view all of it and enjoy it. Although sometimes I find the text dialogue a bit boring and too much perhaps. Yeah, but I want to understand why a lot of people say the story of Final Fantasy XIV online is actually very good, so I do not want to skip any of the dialogue or the cutscenes. So I just want to go over to the NPCs and acknowledge their help, because without them, yeah, I really cannot complete, or I do not think I can successfully complete this dungeon if it's not for the tank always aggroing the mobs and the bosses. I think I would be easily defeated, so I think I would like to acknowledge their help as much as possible. And I like the way they actually look at you, and if you're taller than them, they actually look up at the correct angle. So I really enjoyed my first dungeon. I hope you enjoy this video as well. See you in the next one.